6441. So says the Gemara. So again, one more time. The Kala of Rav Zvidi came and he rebelled against his wife, against her husband. And then what happened was that she had an expensive clothing. So the question is, does she lose it or not? So there were two different versions in the Gemara. The first, these three rabbis, they said that she lost everything. And Rav Gamda said, why? She shouldn't lose it. And according to the other version of the Gemara, they said that she does lose it, right? That she doesn't lose it. He said, you should lose it. Fine. Says the Gemara, hashta de lo itmar lo achi v'lo achi. But at the end of the day, we don't know. So what is it? Does she lose it or not? Tafsa lo mafkina mina. If she grabbed it, so we don't take it away from her. But she already has it in her hands. Lo tafsa, but if she doesn't have it, lo yavinla. We don't give it to her. Umashina la tre sayach eshata gita. And we wait 12 months until we give her the get. Because maybe she's going to retract. Right? But during those 12 months, she doesn't get any parnasa from the husband. We wait for 12 months. Let's see if she's going to retract or not. But during those 12 months, no money from the husband. Nothing whatsoever. So Amar. Ma? Gimara. Amar Rav Tuvi Bar Kisna and Shmuel. Says Rav Tuvi Bar Kisna in the name of Shmuel. Kotvin Igeret Mered Al Arusa. Ve'en Kotvin Igeret Mered Al Shomeret Yavam. You do write an Igeret Mered, which means it's a letter of that she's moredet. Right, it's like a shtar beddin, right? That means basically that they have to write like a letter, and that's what's showing that, you know, that they have on paper that she's moredet, and therefore they're going to start deducting for the money and all these things. So they write her on an usa that she doesn't want to get married. Meaning right now she's supposed to be married. She doesn't say, I don't want to get married to him. Yeah, but you're an usa. I don't want. So they write an igeret mered on an usa, but they don't write an igeret mered on a shomeret yavam, that she doesn't want to get married to the yavam. Okay? So says the Gemara, how could that be? He says, Meitve, we ask a question. Here we put everyone together. We put whether it's going to be an Arusa, Nesua, Nida, Chola, Shomeret Yavam. On all these women, we're going to come and we're going to put, right, that they have the same halachot. So answers the Gemara, Lakashi, it's not a question. Khan, the Braita is talking about Shetava, who? Right? And therefore, which means that Shomeret Yavam wants to get married to her, and she does not want to. The Khan, and here we're talking about Shetavahi, that she wanted to get married. And the Kavanah is that we do not write an Igeret Mered against the Yavam. Not against her. Against the Yavam. We don't write an Igeret Mered. Right? The Amar of Tachlib Abravim and Shmuel Tavahu Niskakin Lo. If he's the one that wants the Yavama, so then the Betim will try to help it. Right? And they're going to write the letter against her. But if she wants to get married to the Yavam and he doesn't want to, Betin do not come and try to help her by starting writing a letter against him. Right? So the Gemara is going to say, how do you know this case of the Shmuel that we just said? Which means that she's the one that she wants to get married to the Yavam. It's written that you're going to write an Igeret Mered Arusa. So it says, La Arusa mi ba'ele. Which means it should be written La Arusa, which means that they're going to do it on the Arus, that he's the one that doesn't want to get married to her, right? That he's the one that's Mured. Okay? So answers the Gemara, Halakha, she asked a question. Tani La Arusa. You're right. We learned you're going to write an Igeret Mered for an Arusa. And we're not going to write it for a Shomeret Yavam. Again, we're always talking about that she's rebelling. Remember that she does not want to have relations with her husband, so therefore that's what's going on. So ask the Gemara, Maishna, what's the difference? Shomeret Yavam de lo, that is Shomeret Yavam that we're not going to write, and he get it. Damnina labels, we're going to tell him Zil, right? Go. Lo mipakta, you're not chayav on the pidya v'rivya. What does that mean? Since the miyun of the Yavam is not going to be merkev, to be mekayem the mitzvah, so therefore there's no din of moret. Meaning like this, he could still have pidya v'rivya with his own wife. So the fact that he doesn't want to get married with a Yavama, that does not make him a moret. He's fulfilling the mitzvah pidya v'rivya. Arusa nami, also an arusa. Neimala, we should come and tell her, Zil, go. Lo mipakt, you're not chayav in pidya v'rivya. So therefore, we're not going to come and make a knas on the arus. Because anyway, she doesn't have to have children. So if she doesn't have the obligation to have children, why are we going to write a letter against him that he doesn't want to give relations to his wife? Ella, but rather, she came because of a ta'ana. What was a ta'ana? The Amra that she says, Baina Khutra Liada Umara Likura. She wants a makel for her hands and she wants a kardum for kever. What does that mean? A woman could come and say that even though she's not chayevet on pidya rivya, she could come and she wants, she says, listen, I want a baston. How do you say baston? I want a cane, right? For the future. And she wants somebody to dig her grave. What does that mean? She wants children, not because of the mitzvah of pidya rivya. She wants children so that way they will help her when she gets older, right? That they're going to come, they're going to care for her. So they're going to, you know, make sure that she has a cane. They'll help her walk around. They'll help her take her places, right? Or to dig her a grave. You understand? So that's what she wants. Yeah? Is so to hear Shomeret Yavam, Yavam Mechamat Tana. The same thing with Shomeret Yavam. The Shomeret Yavam, that means just like an Arusa was not commanded on Pidya Vivya, but she could say this Ta'ana, and we accept it. So to a Shomeret Yavam, she could come and say this Ta'ana, and we accept it. We go against the Yavam. Why? Not because of Pidya Vivya. Because if it's because of Pidya Vivya, right? You know, you're not commanded. So Ella, but rather, EDVD, both cases, we're talking about Tava Hu. What does it mean Tava Hu? Right? That it's the Shomeret Yavam. He wants to have he wants to do Yibum with her. Right? And not her. And she doesn't want. Velo Kashia, and it's not a question. Kan Lachlot, the Kan Yabem. One is talking about Chalisa, and one is talking about Yibum. Tamar Rabbi Pedat Amir Yochanan says, Rabbi Pedat Amir Yochanan, Tava Lachlot. What happens if the Yavam wants to do Chalitza and she doesn't want to do Chalitza? He's kakin lo. We help him in order that he should be able to do the Chalitza. Tavali Yabem. But if he wants to do Yibum and she doesn't want, and he's kakin lo. We don't force it. Right? Why? Because Minastam, maybe he's not Mikavim for Lashem Mitzvah. So therefore, you know, we're not going to come and start forcing her to do Yibum.
She's being so much.
Yeah, maybe it could be that there's other reasons. So ask the Gemara, "Maishnali Yabem Dolo." What's the reasoning by Yibum Lo? The Amrin Lebes, we're going to tell him, "Zilun Sivita, go get married to another woman. Why do you need your sister-in-law? Go get married to another woman." Lachlotz Nami Nimalei. Also by Chalitza, we should tell him, "Zilun Sivita, go get married to somebody else." Ella De'amar, but he's going to say, "Kevin Dagidabi, Lo Kayev Le'achrite." Says no, since the Shomeret Yavam, right, that he could, he's Kshurali, so therefore they're not going to give me another woman. But Achenami So Tuye, Kevin Dagidabi. They're not going to give me anybody else. So therefore, so why did Shimon say that we're not going to bride and get? Basically, he wants to detach himself from her. As long as he's still married to her because he still has to do the Chalitza or the Yibuma, nobody's going to get married to him. They're going to say, go finish off, you know, get rid of, you know, like, you know, finish your business and then come to me. That's what they're going to come and they're going to say. Yeah, so he comes and he says, Ela idi, but rather both cases, Shetavali Yabem, right? It's really Behemet, the Yavam wants to do Yibum. Lakash, that's not a question. There's the first psak and the last psak, right? The tzrambas we learned on the Mishnah Bechorot. Mitzvat Yibum kolalo mitzvah chalitza. What's first, Yibum or chalitza? So there we learned mitzvat Yibum comes before chalitza. But Yishona, that was at the beginning. You should be coming to mitzvah, but they were doing it for mitzvah. But now they don't have covenant for mitzvah. I'm no mitzvah chalitza. Now the mitzvah of chalitza comes before Yibum. Meaning, if somebody comes and he says, "Listen, Rabbi, I want to do everything l'shem shemayim, but what? What should I do? Yibum or chalitza?" Yeah, what should he do? So comes the halacha is that all depends. In the beginning, they always say that Yibum always came before Chalitza. Now they say Chalitza comes before Yibum because if they're not having Kavanah, the Shem Shamayim, it's going to be a problem. And this is by the two dots. Okay? Until when does he bring down the money? So the Gemara there says whether it's going to be the 7 dinarim or the 7 tapakin, and then we said about the 3 and the 3 for the husbands, right? So I asked the Gemara, my trapakin, what is trapakin? We know what dinarim are. What is trapakin? Amar Rav Sheshat, asira, it's a sela medina. Okay? That's a sela medina. Ask the Gemara, how much is a sela medina? Vekama istira, palga de zuza, it's a chetzi zuz suri. Okay? So therefore, it's a half of a zuz suri. So Tanim Yachli also learned in a writer of Yudam and Rabbi says, Shloshat Tarpakin, which is Teisha Ma'im, which is 9 Ma'a, Ma'a Vachetzi Lechol Yom, which is 1.5 for every single day of the week. So Amalei, Rabbi Chia, Bar Yosef, Shumuel, Sadat Yuchay, Rabbi Yosef, to Shumuel, Maishna Ihu De Avilin Le De Shabbat, or Maishna Ihu De Lo Avilin De Shabbat, says one second, why is it that when the woman is Moredet, right, we take it off also, right, because of the, we said that we do 7, right, because of that means it's 1 per day. And when it's going to be that for her, right, we're not giving her the Shabbat, right? Because we're only doing 3 tarpakin. So okay. What's going on exactly? Right? Why is it like, you know, what's going on exactly? So answers the Gemara, Ihi, the mifchat kapachit lo mixi kisachar Shabbat. For her, when you're deducting it, it doesn't look like schar Shabbat, right? Why? Because you're deducting. It's like a knas. So when you're deducting something, it doesn't look like you're taking off for the Shabbat. You, but for him, the osufu kamosvi, that we're actually adding on money to her ketubah, it looks like mixi kischa Shabbat, right? Samagdala namubet, it looks like kischa Shabbat. You understand what happened? By him, right? By him, since she's the one that's rebelling, what are you doing? You're taking off the ketubah. So it doesn't look like anything of schar Shabbat if you're just deducing. She had before 200 zoos, now become 190, now 180, 170, 160. It's going downwards. It's no schar Shabbat. But for if he's the one that's moreh, they're adding on to her ketubah. When they're adding on to her ketubah, what are you adding on? Now you're adding on for Shabbat. So it looks like schar Shabbat. It looks like she's making money on Shabbat. So Amaleh, Shmuel, ma be moreh lemoredet. What's the difference between moreh and moredet? So he comes and says, Amaleh, itzel ma mishuk shel zonot. Go to a shuk shel zonot. Why? Mi sochen mi. Usually the man is the one that's socheret the isha. So you see from here that the man suffers more because there's no relations. Who's suffering more, the man or the woman? Obviously it's the man. So since the man is suffering more because there's no relations, there's more money involved. Meaning there's a bigger knas when she stops him from the relations. Yeah, you're listening. Davar acher, another explanation, right? Yizei yitzro mibachutz, vezu yitzra mibifnim. He says the man is yitzra is mibachutz. And therefore the kishui, right, everything, it's nikar, so he gets embarrassed because he wants to, and he can. So it's got a bigger yitzra, and it's a bigger her yitzra is inside, which means that you cannot see right now her tavot, right? It's a big difference. The man, you could see the kishui. You could see when a person gets an erection, and all of a sudden now he cannot do it. So he gets embarrassed. And what happened? He really wants relations and you're not getting it. The woman, everything is on the inside. Well, so since everything is on the inside, you cannot see it. Since you can't see it, so therefore it's much less of an embarrassment, and therefore it's much less of money that you have to actually come and you're going to pay. Have a wonderful day.